Everywhere that I go, I talk about John. It's almost unheard of that I would give a lecture or a presentation to anybody without talking about John. I always highlight what he's done here, and that helps us bring in the very best students, the very best faculty, and the best researchers into our college. So John's work has elevated the college in almost anywhere that you look.
Being mentored by somebody of Dr. Kopchick's caliber, considering that he is, you know, an expert and a renowned scientist, is a little bit intimidating because the expectations that sets for you. But it's great because it's opened so many opportunities, especially in networking with other scientists. At the conferences we've gone to, just the ability to, you know, be around this group of people that aren't just in the field, but they're experts in the field. And having that opportunity to talk to them about their research and set up collaborations it's phenomenal.
After being in his lab, it's clear he makes research fun. He makes it enjoyable. He has built a community of scholars, many of them from around the world. There's always a visiting scholar in there. Since I've been there, there's been one from Finland, Argentina, Mexico, Spain, you name it. He's got people coming in the lab all the time, so you have the diversity, but he also has a group of students, he's got research scientists from all over, and he really makes people enjoy being there.
In 1981, we both went to the Roche Institute of Molecular Biology, but I actually met him on the same softball team, where he took a bunch of scientists and turned a 0-11 team into an 11-0 championship team. And right then, you can tell from Dr. Kopchick that, you know, the type of leader he was, competitiveness, just his personal ability, you just know he's going to do something.
The drug that John invented has had a profound impact on medicine. Prior to somavert being invented, there was no drug that was specifically a growth hormone antagonist that would treat this condition called acromegaly. And his drug has been remarkable in lengthening people's lives and giving them a better quality of life. I've been to John's lab a number of times, and one of the things I've enjoyed doing is looking at some of the letters that have been sent to him by patients who essentially are thanking him for saving their lives. That's a profound statement, oftentimes overused in medicine, but in John's case, it's absolutely true.
We were sitting around talking, and he said, "So, Darlene, do you want to change the world?" And I said, "What are you talking about? No, not really." And he said, "Well, if you don't want to change the world, you need to get out of science." He said, "You've got to want to change the world." And I thought, at the time, not much of it, but then as I look back, I mean, he has done that. He's changed the world forever in terms of growth hormone or growth hormone research for many people.
With all his incredible success, he's won awards not only all over the country, but all over the world. He's won awards from places like MD Anderson, the very top of the medical world. He has invented this drug that has made the university millions of dollars and saved countless lives. And yet, to talk to him, he's as down to earth and is as nice a person as anybody I know. And you would never know, sitting there talking to John, that he is a world famous researcher and somebody of that stature. I'm just very honored to be able to know him.